Okay, all right. Got another video here. We're going to take a look at the Buck 110. The classic legendary knife. That's over 50 years old. So this is old enough to be some people's grandfather. Some of them knives out there, some of them newer knives, yeah. They come out in the 90s and so forth. Yeah, this knife right here could be their grandfather. They've been influenced heavily by this knife. So yeah, I'm a big fan of the Buck 110. And almost any knife that's a similar rendition of it. I like this design. I like the look of it. I think it's all classy. And even though it's a big heavy knife, it's not a what they call tactical knife. And which is where tactical can be overemphasized in a lot of ways. You know what I'm saying? Because tactical to me is not a look or a device. It's a state of mind. You know, you think tactically or tech with tack. You don't buy something that's tactical, but you know, nevertheless, certain implements bring tactical into play. So now, knowing that this is not a combat tactical knife, but a hunting knife, we're gonna keep it as what it is. This is a nice knife with brass bolsters. It's got a clip point blade made of 440C steel, and I must say it is, you know, a very, very good looking and attractive knife. And it's one that I try my best to, you know, to call myself a collector of. You know, I got a lot of knives, but I actually call myself a collector of buck knives. You know, I try to collect different buck knives, but I have various different knives as well. So this is an older model. This one here is a knife that was made between 1974 and 1980. It's got buck on the tang, buck 110 USA, and the 110 got a dot on each side, a little star or a little dot on each side. And the ones with the dot on each side of the 110 came out between 1974 and 1980, or maybe 1976, I'm not sure. But it's either 1974 or 1976, all the way up into 1980. So yeah, this is a good old knife right here. This is one of the original looks. And if you can look at them, you can see the difference in the bolster. This one's a lot thicker. This one is rounded off more. So they did a good job making the knife more contourable to the hand. And less blocky, you know. So the wood doesn't feel as good because it is kind of old. I mean, being as though it's at least as old as 1980s. So with that being said, you know, like I said, this is one that I'm try to buy one at least one a year or one every 2 years, because you know, just to get the different tamps thing that this on it to signify the year just they came out in. Sitting right here before me, I got two with the same tamp sting and two more with difference. These two have the same, came out the same year, and these two came out different years. So this is 1 year and this is another year. This is the most recent one. That's why it looks so nice and pretty. I bought this one this year. It's just got a backward C or half a block with a dot in the middle. And this one has a half circle with the top part of the circle up and a dot in the middle. This one has a circle with the circular part to the right and the dot. And this one also has the same circle with the circular part to the right, curve to the right, with the dot in the middle. So these are the same, these two. You know, I bought them the same year. This one I bought a different year, and this one I bought recently. This one was a real reasonable price. I just got it from Walmart. Came in this package. And the first time I ever seen one that came in a package with the knife actually open. And it's got the 420 with the Bose heat treatment. Say, cryogenic heat treat stainless steel. Cryogenic heat treated stainless steel. Lock back designed for safe use. A buck classic. And you know, all that is true. But what gets me on these knives that I've never seen before. And I want to see if I can get that to stand out. I found that to be very surprising. Okay, it says this product contains chemicals known to the state of California to cause cancer, birth defect, or reproductive harm. Now, I find that, you know, a little disappointing in a buck knife, especially a buck 110 folder. So just so you can see that this is the buck 110 folder, ever warranty. Having that on the back of the package. All the way down. It's very upsetting and very, you know, depressing. Not depressing, but it's upsetting. You know. I mean, I've never known it for a knife to have any cancer-causing products in it. This product contains chemicals known to the state of California to cause cancer, birth defects, or other reproductive harm. I mean, you know, reproductive harm is your lifeline, you know? And, you know, knife ain't supposed to do that. And here's another one that I got. I haven't even taken out the box. You know, it's about 50th anniversary knife. And, it's got the little warning on there also. See, I guess I haven't been reading the package that much. Because this one says, this product contains a chemical or substance. I like to know what chemical or substance that is. Known to the state of California to cause cancer, birth defects, or reproductive harm. Now, that's some pretty tough pill to swallow. You know? But yeah, so, and you wonder why people buy these, you know, this is an old knife, but this is a Japanese knife. I don't know if you can make it out, but if you can, it says Klein Tools Incorporated, Japan. It's a good knife. I don't know if it has any cancer-causing chemicals in it or not, but I doubt if it do. See, this is something new because we ain't been always having products with this kind of inscription on the package. This is an old Pakistan knife, you know, a rendition of the Buck 110. You know, not the finest knife in the bunch, but it will do the job. And so are these, which I did a little review on before. You know, they're also from Pakistan, and this one as well. And then we have the little Winchester knife. I think this one has some of them chemicals in it also. Opens real easy with one hand. Awesome little point on it. But kind of makes you wonder, what is it? What chemical is they using that could cause the cancer? You know, and I got a lot of these knives. You know? So we got four here. Then we got another one here. 2014 model. Which is the 50th year. And all of these are before that one. These on down. This is the newest one, I think is. May come out just this year alone. That's why it's got the newer box with the warning on it. So, yeah, I'm a big buck fan. Got sheaves up here. And this is the newest sheath. This one got the embroidery made into the sheath. That may be where the cancer-causing product is right here. You know? And then you got this. These are some of the newer sheaths. See, the one is embroidered, the other one is kind of stitched on with a patch. And then we have the leather one, which I like the leather more, but most of the ones come now come with the nylon sheath. And this leather, when I got it, it was so tight fitting the knife in there that I had to leave it in the car a couple days in the heat for it to soften up so the knife could fit in and out of there without being pressed together so much. You know, that's why they often have this little spring like this. You take them, you can see them press down. Okay, when they fit in the more tight sheaths. But yeah, this is a look at my Buck collection and other knives that are similar renditions of it, you know. And I'm going to continue to collect them. You know, like I said, I don't think it's nothing in the steel. Because the steel is what touches your food and the knife. Maybe it's the sheath. It could be the knife, though. But nevertheless, something they feel as though they need to warn you about for the state laws of California to let you know this cancer-causing agent or chemical in the product. So, thanks for watching. And this is the Buck Knife Collection from a Buck Knife Collector. I have others. And this is my very first 119 right here. And this is my second. And I have others of these, but you know, I would never thought that a regular 110 would have that on it. And ain't no coating on the blade, any of that. So, you know, I'm gonna cut this video short. I appreciate whoever watches it, and if you didn't know about the 119, you do now, as far as it being a nice knife, but having that warning on it. So peace, take care, and be blessed.